based out in Vienna are. We don't know the setup of the hotel or anything. I've been focused on handling the streaming end of things and a few other bits and pieces and driving signups and whatnot. So, but what I am going to say, and kind of put it in perspective, is League of Legends, right? Riot, yeah, bit of this, right? They put together the season two finals and they had to postpone it a week. I mean, an actual week. You had to fly all the players out again. Build, while they were building a big stadium around them, you could see some of the games that were left over, like the semi-finals and stuff. And there was cranes in the background, like beep, 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 doing the reversing noise with orange lights and stuff. And, you know, if you think, oh, well, that's esports, yeah, esports is a joke. Did anyone watch the Super Bowl? I watched the Super Bowl. I saw an hour and a half, hour and 40 minute delay due to a power cut after Beyonce was out there, although she wasn't the cause, allegedly. And that almost perverted the result of the game because the Baltimore Ravens were all ancient and knackered.
Okay, so not to interrupt you there, Gons, because you do have some very valid points, but it seems like we are going to switch over the coverage here. We're going to jump into 3D Max and ESports Serbia. So let's see if ESports Serbia can actually maintain the sort of, you know, the underdog status that they've had, or if they're now going to become one of the favourites to finish in a seeded position. So interesting to see. I mean, 3D Max, obviously, if you are a CSS guy, you will know them as the old Reason team for the most part. Players like Guardian, PHP and Snikes, obviously just stalwarts of the... Of the CSS European scene. I'd say more the UK scene, because he went on that absolute tear at the I-Series, even though obviously, you know, the Czechs, they had tied the record for most I-Series victories in a row with Salvo at the time, which was three tournaments in a row. So there is potential here on 3D Max, but to be honest, they haven't really shown that so far in Go, have they?
No, not at all. Like the favourites for this game, obviously for me, is ESports Serbia, and having... been a part of the Source scene as well. When I started playing Source, that team existed like in 2007 or something. They were about the worst team I've ever played in Counter-Strike ever. But the thing about them, they stuck together as a team for 3 years, and then they dominated the entire scene.
Yeah.
And that's the problem with Counter-Strike and any other team-based game.
Well, everybody's looking for the quick fix.
Yeah, people don't understand that. It's sometimes you get lucky with the quick fixes, but you need to put in the work and the time to become a dominant force. But take it away, bro.
Yep, so we're in game now. 4-3 in favour of ESports Serbia. Not sure if this is first or second half. Looking at the scoreboard, it does seem like it is first half. So the CT bias, not really playing them that much of a factor. Saying that, the rush coming through from KGR there onto ramp room, that's going to really open up the CTs here. YNK going to drop the outside push from 3D Max. It does seem like we are going to see a rotation down to the lower side. So let's see if I can find out who's actually pushing towards lower. We've got Cappy here. He's going to be making his way in from the just from under the ladder. Spot one opens up with the... he should have had that kill a little bit sooner then, but doesn't matter. No harm, no foul. He gets it anyway. Switches out for the M4 from that Galil. Here we go. This is going to be the big push coming in from KGR. And I think that was four kills that round for KGR, in fact. So just, four times the M4 frags. So
yeah.
Picks up the cheeky George Foreman. And that really does put ESports Serbia into a dominant position here. If they can hold out now for the next... next five rounds, they'll walk away heads held high here on the first half, won't they?
Yeah, absolutely. And I just need to point it out for people who come from 1.6 or Counter-Strike Source or even Condition Zero, if you want. If you're just tuning in and like, never seen Counter-Strike Global Offensive before, what they've done is changed the map so that it's a lot more accessible for the Ts to get to the lower side from outside. It's a lot easier. As you can see on the screen there, there's a pathway down on the right where... you can just head down the stairs and you'll go on to the lower side. So they've balanced out the map a little bit better than before, but it's still CT biased, and ESports Serbia are showing it with a 6-3 scoreline thus far.
Yep, I'd still say it was a 10-5 map just because that upper site is so hard to broach. Now, the fact that they've changed the mid cover does make it a little bit easier to defend a plant because you can do the whole ring around the roses bit.
Yeah.
But that only lasts for so long, because eventually, even if you are walking, sprinting, breaking your momentum, you know, changing the path that you're going around, you still are going to get caught after a certain amount of time. So that upper site, still very hard to take and hold. Lower site, a lot more accessible, but you still have the same issues in holding that lower site, where you've got the rotations coming in from ramp room and from top ladder. If the top ladder rotator is quick down those vents or down through ramp, still very hard to hold. So I'd still say 10-5. But a little bit less 10-5, if you get what I'm saying.
Yeah, yeah, it's less biased, but it's still a CT map. Yeah, I totally agree with you. But I like the subtle changes they've done to it. Oh, what's going on here? He's sneaking in. Oh, he will get that hope and a kill.
It does seem like Esports Serbia going for the complete lockout here. Guardian, your last man alive. He does manage to drop down into vents onto lower site. He's going to be looking for that bomb. He does manage to pick it up. Now, he's really got to be cautious here, because the second the Serbians hear that beep, 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 they are going to drop vent and they're probably going to wreck him. So it's quite fortunate there, actually. It seems like EMI was actually in the rotation from outside. And Nickel, I don't even know how you pronounce that. I'm just going to call him Nickel for the time being. He's actually delayed his push down, which is something we didn't see from IMG earlier. So it seems like Esports Serbia have a good understanding of fundamental retakes here, which is always nice to see. Doors being closed. It looks like they are going to go for the defusal here. Guardian now pushing out. Opens up. The defuse comes in, though. That's unfortunate for Guardian. He's going to be looking for the frag, but he's not going to find it. Probably the smart thing to do, though, would have been to save that AK, really, wouldn't it?
Yeah, no.
I can understand why he would go for the frag. Obviously, he's upset. But, you know, cooler head should have prevailed there, and he should have saved that 2,500, in my opinion.
Yeah, I mean, it's not much he could do different in that position. Like, you would have a guy on the defuse anyways. The only places he really needed to cover was the vents. And he doesn't really need to come off the defuse, because obviously his teammate is just either baiting out the time or getting the kill. So he played it out the way he should be. He should have just hit better and get that headshot.
Well, yet another full buy, 7-3 the scoreline here. We are seeing the push outside from 3D Max. And this used to be Reason Gaming's probably strongest map for my money.
Yeah.
Back in the day, but you wouldn't know that from watching 3D Max. Obviously, different team, different game. So the sort of comparison is probably not fair, to be honest, but I would have expected a little bit more from 3D Max here. Then again, CT bias, they've got 3 rounds on the board. They can pick up 2 more rounds here. They're sitting fairly pretty coming into that second half. It's not ideal, obviously. It doesn't mean that you are devastatingly dependent on the pistols, but I mean, one of these things now that we are seeing here is basically 3D Max just seem to be running around trying to get picks, and it's not working for them, is it?
No, not at all. And they kind of need, even though it's a CT bias map, they need at least 2 more rounds on this map. It's not acceptable to get less than 5 rounds, and even if you get those 5 rounds, you're not going to be completely pleased with your performance.
Yep.
You'll always be looking to get that 6th or even more rounds.
Well, there's the final kill from EMI. That's going to be basically 3D Max shut down yet again, so 8-3 now the scoreline. Really, it's like I said before on trains, knives are so important on CT bias maps. Anytime you get that side pick on the CT side, it sets you up, and you have that leeway in the second half where you don't have to stress out if you lose pistols, because you know you've still got, even after the pistols and the 2 ecos, you know you've still got 2 rounds on your opponent.
Yeah, exactly.
So really, I mean, at this point now, you would have to say that the considered favorite here has got to be Esports Serbia. And like I said, I did have a few people message me and say, like, you got to keep an eye on these guys. They're actually going to be one of those teams that are going to upset, you know, some of the top-tier teams. So, it's like I said, it's really good to see new talent on the scene, basically. Guardian with those nades going outside. Didn't manage to tag anyone with that, though, so wasted $300, though. I'm going to see Snake start to move in with the AK-47. Now, one thing that 3D Max have done well is they have done these outside pushes to perfection, but they just haven't converted the position into frag so far, have they, Walkman?
No, not at all. They always get down to this position. They always get to that lower bomb set, but they lose too many players getting the bomb down, which makes it very hard to cover ST after in the after plant. And also, the removal of the back vents onto the short hallway has made it a lot more difficult for the T's to defend, really. It's not many positions you can stand in after playing here, Jay.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, you've seen the retake coming in now. It does look like EMI is going to grab that headshot onto Cappy, and it looks like, oh, PHP in the vents, he's going to be shut down eventually. We are seeing this retake, fairly successful retake so far. PHP is in a position to stop this. He pulls him off the bomb, frag though. Do we have enough time for the defusal? I think we do. Yep, we should see the defusal come in here. Literally, a whisker in it, but doesn't matter as long as it gets defused and it doesn't explode. That's a round over to Esports Serbia, and now we're seeing a scoreline of 9-3. So, distinct possibility of 12-3 here. If it does go 12-3, can you see any way back for 3D Max?
Yeah, I can. Win the pistol round, get the momentum rolling, then they can easily win it 14-0 in the second half. I just have to add that I'm really surprised about PHP's choice to keep on with that duel in that 1-on-1 after plant. Like he got the CT off the bomb, and the second you know the CT is off the bomb, you run away.
Yeah, you wait to hear that diffuse again.
Yeah,
hit the door again. You pull him off it. You just play the bomb as if it's, you know, at this level of play, you should not be seeing mistakes like that.
No.
Especially from a player the caliber of PHP, who for my money was one of the not necessarily the most standout players individually, but his game sense was second to none back in the day, so very surprising. It could have just been a gamble on his part where he thought, well, maybe I'll just get the frag and that'll work out better for us, but obviously it did not. Now, the ramp entry being shut down, two kills from KGR and Nick with one to follow it up, so all of those headshots, no chance for even a bullet back from 3D Max there on the entry. And as you can see, they're pretty much suppressed in ramp room here. They're being pushed from lobby. We are going to see Nico move in. AK-47 frag onto... Well, I was going to actually give you the name then, but it's pointless because the round's over now. PHP, the final man to fall, and that's now, well, pretty much what you would expect from a CT side, those 10 rounds on the board. At this point now, if ESports Serbia pick any more rounds, they've got to be thinking, well, we're in the ascendant position, we should be walking away from this with a victory.
Yeah, a CT, you will be more than pleased with 11 rounds. Considering you only need, if they get 12-3, they only need to win a pistol round to kind of, then they've secured the draw.
Yep.
Which is valuable in for their group. It's going to be great for them, and also obviously the momentum and nice kill here with that AWP. See what happens.
Side, you see KGR also providing cover with that AK-47, so that's going to allow YNK to actually get back here. And I was going to say he had a grenade in hand. He was in perfect position to actually put some damage onto Guardian, but Guardian does manage to get those 7-6-2 rounds on target before the grenade is released. You see 3D Max here. This is the first round where they've really had an advantage, but they haven't got a position here. So are they able to capitalize on this walk line? I mean, you can see that we've just got another headshot coming in, so that's EMI dropped. They are in a position now where if they put this bomb down, surely advantage 3D Max, and they can make this a somewhat respectable scoreline.
Yeah, now that Snake's got that kill as well, I would say that it's going to be an easy round for 3D Max to pick up. But if they stuck together, those two CTs that were still alive on 100 HP, they would have a great chance of actually succeeding in this round, to be honest, considering the amount of health on the 3D Max squad. But yeah, good to see 3D Max picking up that round. And from our point of view, I would say that we would want 3D Max to win this last one as well.
Yeah, most definitely. Give us a standard 10-5 scoreline, and that way when they go into second half, you know, they're not despondent about it, because 10-4, I mean, it's only one round, but yeah, you know that you've got no margin for error if you go in with anything other than 10-5. I mean, even at 10-5, it doesn't leave you much wiggle room on pistols. You still need the pistols at that point, but if you lose pistols, it's not, you know, it's not the game signed, sealed, and delivered to your opponent, whereas if it's 10-4, pretty much is, really.
Yeah.
Well, seeing the standard sort of setup here that you would have seen in, I suppose, both in CS16 and CSS. Obviously, the flashbangs and the peaks are a bit different, but you're seeing what would have been good old Red Rock in 1.6 being sort of the position to set up from. It does look like, because Sad has taken quite a bit of damage, though. He's had 51 HP removed at the start of the run, and it seems like 3D Max have recognized that the shift has come in, so they're going to start to rotate. It's not going to stop Nico picking up double kills with the M4, though. It looks like we'll see two in return from the AK-47. That's going to be Nico and KGR both dropped, so Bligi here could actually get in on ramp. Can he drop lower, though? That's the question. I mean, there's nobody there to stop him. Kassad is in those vents, but as you can see, he's relatively low health, so in a straight-up 1v1 firefight, you would expect that 3D Max should come out on top of this here.
Yeah. And it's down to 3v1 now. Kassad can surely not take this. No, he can't. It's 10-5, and 3D Max shouldn't be disheartened at all by that. They know they're going to get the easy side now, where everyone feels more comfortable. If they win the pistol round, I have no doubt that they will take this game.
Yep. I honestly think now this pistol round is so pivotal.
Yeah.
It's a cliche term in Counter-Strike. I've said it so many times, but the reason I've said it so many times is because it rings true.
Yeah.
And especially in Gold World, you know, pistols are seemingly more of a factor in the game, especially in over 1.6. I mean, Source, yeah, you did have more decos in Source than in 1.6, really, but the pistol round here is literally what's going to dictate, I believe, who wins this game.
Yeah. Looks like we got a fake onto that upper bomb. So 3D Max picking up the two first kills here.
And we've got a dive lower as well, so it does seem like we are seeing a bit of a shift here in strat from ESports Serbia. They're going to actually shift back up towards ramp room now, so really, it's not looking good here for ESports Serbia. It looks like they are going to drop this round, and 3D Max are going to be in a position where they're going to make that scoreline just a two-point deficit after the two ecos. Saying that, YNK's got something to say about it. He's not going to go without a fight here. Taking a lot of fire from over towards the right vent, though. The T-vent, and he's going to be shut down. Nicely done. Headshot, but obviously we do still have two members of 3D Max in play. It's going to be Guardian and Blue Jeep. And there's the kill. It was a mere formality at that point. The second he dropped vent, the rotation came in. A couple of bullets to finish the job, and that's going to be 3D Max with the pistol round that they so needed. 10-6 now, the scoreline, and you have to say, 3D Max could very well get themselves back into this game now.
Yeah, if it all goes to plan, they will decrease the deficit to 8-10 after this. But I have to point out, it was a great effort in that 1v3, 1v4 even. It just really well played out by him, and lucky that it didn't... I was hoping for a 1v1 there, to be honest, in that pistol.
I nearly got to that point, but unfortunately for... I was going to say unfortunately for the viewers, but then again, I suppose the fact that 3D Max did manage to pick up the victory is going to extend this game, which has been pretty good so far from what we've seen of it.
Nice shot from Guardian there.
Yep, opening up with the FAMAS. It does seem like we are going to see Snipes with a kill as well. Now, there's the second kill on Guardian this round. Are we going to see... Yep, looks like Esports Serbia starting to shift towards the lower site. Now, are they going to sell this as a fake? I think the appropriate thing to do here is the fake and go top ladder. Are they going to be capable of picking up on that, though?
It really depends. I think they're just standing here, seeing if they can get an easy pick onto that lower bomb site, seeing as they got that FAMAS in hand. So currently, they were a bit... they had no idea where they were going. They just wanted to see if the CTs pushed offensive somewhere. And now that they see that the CTs are playing it out smartly and passively, they just have to decide to go somewhere. And this is not the best place to go.
No. Cappy had the perfect counter to that push then. Really, maybe the appropriate thing to do wouldn't have been to go top ladder. It might have been just to sit ramp room and save that for mass. But then again, I mean, it's not like that was a critical situation for Esports Serbia. Obviously, coming into the second half with the lead, they're not going to be sweating losing a deco like that, even if it was, you know, one that they could have picked up a couple of frags, done some cash damage on. To be honest, such a heavily CT-sided map, cash damage on weapons isn't really a factor, is it?
Not as much as all the maps, but obviously it's always good. All the small advantages you can get is going to add themselves together, and in the end you win the game by it. So, let's see here. Still an eco for the teams here. Well, they got the kill. Oh, see ya.
No, KGR just trying to get through Squeaky, but it's not going to happen for him. He's going to be shut down by the Guardian for mass play. I think that was a hat-trick that round for Guardian as well, so he's going to be padding his stats against the old Eco Bash. Always looks good. He's at 19-10 right now, so right at that 2-1 kill-to-death ratio point. He's got 3 MVP stars on his score sheet right now. Second place, that's going to be... how do you even pronounce that name?
Which one?
The second place. I've been calling him Bleach, but I mean...
Just call him B-Dog, man. It's fine.
There we go. Yeah, B-Dog. Okay, so B-Dog on 17-12. And PHP bringing up the rear for 3D Max right now. So it's looking like really at this point, 3D Max have managed to claw their way back into this game. The fact that they've now got that CT bias working for them, I would have to say this puts them in sort of the position where it's their game to lose.
Yeah, it is. Yes, I think Esports Serbia is under pressure now. Obviously, this is going to be a huge round for them to bring back the momentum, and not only the point, but the momentum to see, like to give the notice to 3D Max that, hey, we're pretty good at T as well. And we've got a little lag there, but that's fine. It's down to 4v4.
It does look like we are seeing a lower site rotation here, so maybe... 3D Max have done inkling that something's coming. Yep, as you can see, YNK actually jumping through the window side. Does open up with the AK-47, grabs himself the frag, and now we are going to see that bomb go down on the lower site. The rotation a little bit slow in coming in here from 3D Max. I would have expected that a little bit sooner, considering they was pretty much swarming that upper site. I would have expected a vent dive a little bit quicker than that, but the retake is in position now. You can see Cap, he's going to be moving up towards ramp room. Opens up with the M4, grabs the headshot. Kassad, though, with the AK-47 frag just momentarily before that onto PHP. Does look like we are going to see it down to a one-on-one here. If he's being faked, the AK opens up though, and that's going to be the round. That was really smart play there from EMI. He knew that that wasn't going to be a full attempt, so he has a peek, opens up with the AK, and catches Cappy facing the exact wrong way. So good play, but perhaps a little bit more communication required there from 3D Max, to be honest.
Yeah, a bit of a ballsy move, like seeing the doors are open. walking with
the check vent first.
Yeah, yeah. What I would have done was move over and just close the doors, really.
Yeah, and then that way you can check vent.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And then you can check the door whenever you want. And
I mean, to be honest, if it would have worked, then we'd be calling him a genius because he wouldn't have, you know, we wouldn't have had any inkling from the noise of the door being
very
closed.
Very true.
But I would say, as a percentage, that's only going to work a very, very small percentage of the time. Maybe like 10% of the time you would get that vent kill where somebody rotates around. Because you don't really see that much vent play these days on CSGO. I mean, 1.6 and CSS, obviously, the vent dives and such were obviously a huge part of Nuke, but not as much these days. So really, it seems to be that the switch to outside has seemed to open up the map in a completely different way, but it's kept it around about the same balance, I would say. So that quick T dive is, to be honest, it was very easily countable. Double nade and M4 fire would always stop that rush. So the fact that they've opened outside makes it, from my estimation, a better map.
We had a very offensive B-dog outside, but he didn't manage to pick up the kill. He actually got tagged quite heavily down to 37. And Karsan and Nicolini gets picked off there.
As you can see, this ramp push now coming to fruition. It looks like it is going to be shut down, though. B-dog again, double frags with that M4 and M4 headshot onto KGR. As you can see, 3D Max in a beautiful position here. They had double cover on that approach from outside. And really not much that Y&K could do in that position, was the Walkler?
No, at all. He could have saved the weapon, because I don't think they've got the best economy right now. Now, there we go. They've gone eco now. I still want to call it deco, but obviously they're not buying deagles.
Have we even seen a deagle in this tournament so far?
I don't think I've noticed it, at least. So after this eco, 3D Max should be looking at a 10-11 score line should really start to get the lead soon if they want to get back into this game. And I see no reason why they shouldn't be able to pick it up.
Well, score line of 11-9 here, so Esports Serbia really, I'd say this is an even game right now. That score line being 11-9, this could go either way, to be honest, which is nice. I mean, normally in this position you would just see the CT steamroll. Unless it was a completely unbalanced match, you know, between a seeded team and an unseeded team, normally you would see that bias kick in. Less of an issue these days, which is quite nice, actually. I was saying about the metagame and how I didn't like changes to the metagame, but the more and more I get used to it, the less likely we are to see blowout games, the better it is for esports in general, I think. So, anyway, that's going to be the eco bash out of the way. So the mere formality of that round has been put to one side now. It brings the scoreline to 11-10. So 3D Max here, clawing slowly but surely back into contention, but they really can't afford any slip-ups here. I mean, just sort of one bad eco, you know, where they get completely steamrolled on an eco, and that will cost them the game, won't it?
Yeah, it will. Let's see, unless they do something offensive straight off the bat. I would like to check the economy of the UTs here. They are a bit passive.
As you can see, we've only got two flashbangs in play at the moment, so they're going to have to coordinate the entry onto the bomb site with both of those flashbangs just to get in, and that leaves basically no backup for cancelling a retake. So really now, I would say, given the fact that the buy is so light, 3D Max should pick up this round quite easily. His PHP grabs two AK headshots, making it look all so easy. EMI moving around the outside. He is going to take down Guardian. It's interesting to see Guardian playing outside without an AWP.
Yeah, I'm really surprised seeing it, and I don't understand why. It would be interesting to know why he's decided to drop that AWP.
Well, I mean, the AWP is a little bit sort of, I wouldn't use the term broken, but it's not as it should be. I think that will be patched to, you know, being correct eventually. But I mean, Guardian was always a decent rifler, but he was never a standout rifler. I mean, I would always put an AWP in his hands before I would give him an assault rifle.
Everyone went jumped on the bandwagon saying that Guardian was a cheater in back in Source. Then he went on LAN, and then everyone went mute all of a sudden.
Yeah,
he's a beast, and he's been playing a lot of 1.6 as well.
Well, you know why that was? It's because when he replaced WT, he did it so well.
Yeah.
So people assume, you know, WT being the god of the AWP that he was, somebody coming along and putting in. At first, he did drop off a little bit, but I'd say after about 3 or 4 months, he was putting out the same sort of figures that WT was. So automatically, that leads to pack accusations. No reason why. You know, nothing ever was proven, and nothing even suspicious was shown. So I don't know where the accusations came from. Probably just jealous players, to be honest.
But yeah, we see another eco here from Esports Serbia, which means that 3D Max should be able to claw their way into the lead for the very first time here. And from there, it should really be easy to take it home.
Very passive start here from both teams. 3D Max not willing to force the issue, and ESports Serbia looking to get maybe an M4 here early and use that to their advantage. We do have entry coming in onto this upper site. Flashbang's going in. It looks like we're going to see B-Dog with the shutdown. We're going to have to follow up with the M4 kill. AGR and Nico, you can both grab pistol kills, so it's not completely one-way traffic here with the drop down to the lower site as well. Did he have the bomb though? They do have the bomb, so KGR selling the fake, but he gets caught by Cappy. Good idea. Just seemed like Cappy was onto that from pretty much the get-go. So kind of unfortunate, but then again, it makes it a more interesting game now with 3D Max in the ascendant position. First time we have seen that. The pistols might have gone their way, but obviously because we were in the game earlier with Navi and M Faculty, we switched games, so we missed the pistols.
I think the first three rounds that 3D Max got ST probably was off the pistols. But yeah, it's good to see them in lead now. Hopefully Serbia will be able to pick up a few more rounds, but it's going to be hard for them really. But they do pick off Guardian, and that's because he does not have an AWP.
I am still so confused by that. Why would you not give him the AWP? I mean, even if he can't afford it, buy it and drop it.
I have no good reply to that, really. He probably just dislikes the AWP so much. Oh, PHB, will you be able... He's the gun! Takes him out.
If PHB would have been a little bit quieter, then he could have perhaps got a knife kill out of that. But at this level of play, always go for the headshot. Why miss that back? You know, the risk of missing a backstab, hitting somebody in the chest, and then getting
at
shut down.
At 12 to 11 at a LAN, you don't go for the knife kill.
Exactly. So I can understand why he did what he did in that situation. Perhaps he could have been a little bit stealthier about it, but he still picked up a frag anyway. So did lose some 27 HP, but I'm pretty sure he's not sweating 27 HP at his level of play. Anyway, it looks like we are seeing the lower site plank coming in now, and the B-bomb site being overwhelmed. The rotation going to be coming in momentarily. Let's find out where Cappy is. Cappy coming down from top ladder, so that's the start of the rotation. Looks like B-Dog going to be moving in with the HE, so her in the site here. The door's blown off. That's a very smart move. One of the things that I have been seeing more in go of, you know, the destruction of the doors, while they're left for dead, because then obviously that gives your opponent less places to hide.
And he got the kill as well with HE, but once again, 3D Max fails to retake that lower bomb site. So I think we will see ESports Serbia continue their focus onto that lower bomb site, because they have, every time they put down the bomb, they pretty much just won it.
Yeah.
So I'd be surprised if they decided to choose another strategy, even though they know that 3D Max will expect them to go lower site. I don't see.
Well, it's one thing to expect something; it's a completely different kettle of fish to stop it, isn't it?
Exactly. If it ain't broken, don't fix it. It really does apply.
Well, we are seeing a bit of a hot rush though. It's been shut down. No PHP taking a lot of damage from the AK fire from Y and K. So. Some 60 HP removed. He did manage to get out of there without taking enough damage to drop him. Though. Speaking of being dropped, Guardian looking to shut down outside. And really at this point now, with KGR opening up the approach to the inside drop now, it does seem like at this point, ESports Serbia with the positional advantage, even if they don't have the... I was going to say even if they don't have the numbers advantage, but YNK's just level it back up at 2 apiece. PHP dropped down some 8 HP. Let's follow where he is. He's very vulnerable in there. He knows that he heard basically bouncing of a grenade. He didn't know if it was going to be a flash or smoke, so he decided to retreat a little bit. Now double smoke and flash going down. Looks like KGR with that headshot from above.
He's going to shut down. So
first successful retake here in a long time. In fact, I think that's the first successful retake of the second half, isn't it?
Yeah, well, but it was on the upper bomb site, so they kind of went for the... they tried to do something else that what was working. To me, it doesn't make sense.
Yeah,
they tried to outsmart their opponents, but in the end...
Outsmarted themselves, basically.
Yes, they did. Stick to what you know best, and you'll have a lot better chance of succeeding. 13 to 12, and I don't think... if ESports Serbia loses this round, they will be on an eco, I think.
You'd actually anticipate that. I mean, they're fully bought up now, and they've been bought up for the past two previous rounds, so... this loss here could set them back quite a little bit, to be honest.
Yeah.
Scoreline 13-12, there is literally no margin for error here. This is going to be one of those pivotal rounds in Counter-Strike that could very well decide the placings of this group. So, wouldn't be surprised to see some very passive play from both teams here. You see just a little bit of feeling out process going down early. Nico and PHP exchanging some blows, but nothing to really write home about. Now, this is where the action is really going to start. Guardian on the outside, going to flash for cover. It does seem like we've got the ramp push coming in, though. As you can see, four members of Serbia now pushing down towards ramp. Should be a dead giveaway that it's going to be a lower site push here, but still, no rotation from 3D Max. You think maybe at least top ladder would have moved by now, you know, and gone over towards vents or something.
Well, yeah, but the thing is, 3D Max is not playing anyone on ramp. They're playing it defensive from lower side, so it's hard to give information you don't have yet. That but they should have a more accessible rotator than what they're using now, because it takes way too much for that lower guy to get help. Oh, is that our first TK?
That's the first TK of this game. Yeah. I think that was an excusable TK, though. It's kind of one of those where it wasn't, you know, like we saw in the very games earlier, where it should never have happened.
But it will be. It will probably cost them the round. It's down to 3v2 now, and KGR down on basically no HP now. It's going to be really hard for them to win this round. Oh, they do pick up that HE.
Nice. Well, what was a 3-on-2 is now a 1-on-1. KGR going to be peppering for the smoke. Is he going to get it? Is he going to ninja it? Well, KGR probably sweating bullets right now, but he did manage to go clutch there and secure the kill on the diffuser. So another round in favor here of Team Esports Serbia. That breaks the momentum of Max, and we're now seeing a tied game, 13 apiece. This has actually been one of the more entertaining games. I can't believe I'm actually going to say this. I'm somewhat glad that we didn't end up covering the Navi game, which we could still perhaps jump in at the end of this. We're not sure where that's up to at the moment. I think
still players on that server. So
they're still having issues over there. So we could still perhaps get coverage of that in. But perhaps you know the silver lining to the cloud is the fact that we've seen such a good game between two teams who are on the upswing here in CSGO. So as you can see, Kathy pushing outside with that pistol headshot. Mixed bag of tricks here coming in from 3D Max. They've managed to capture two AKs now, so they are going to put those to good use. You see the lower site push coming in, though, from Esports Serbia, and really good anticipation there on the outside push from Esports Serbia. They realized what was going on, decided, well, you know, they're outside, it's going to take them a long time to get the rotation in, it's going to allow us to set up on the lower site. Let's just make the plant now.
Yeah, they got basically no HP either. He picks up three. Oh, no, he only got two of them kills. And it's down to a 1v2 and Cappy only on 12 HP. Going to save that weapon, nothing else to do. And Serbia will be in a 14-13 lead here.
Yep, so close to game point, they can almost taste it at this point. Good move by Cappy here to actually get out with that AK-47. That could very well be the difference. If you stick Cappy down on lower site now, even down there, let him do a bit of damage, get a couple of frags, remove a couple of weapons, and perhaps you could see a miracle retake, but to be honest, that's kind of clutching at straws here at this point.
We are having a buy from 3D Max here, so
they're forcing the issue. And as you can see, it's not a full buy. We got B Dog out there with just one flash. In fact, yeah, I mean we've got a few people who are fully bought, but not across the board here, which is going to be a bit of an issue. But that CT buyer should counteract that, to be honest. So we should see 3D Max here sitting pretty comfortably. As long as we don't see any miraculous play from the likes of KGR here, who's pushing into the upper site from Squeaky. Drops the bomb off. Very smart play, though. We've seen that a couple of times so far in this tournament where players have pushed positions where they shouldn't have pushed for the bomb.
Yeah.
And we've seen that bomb in a very awkward 3-3 position. There's no excuse for that at this level of play. So to see KGR dropping that bomb off as he makes a peek is very smart play. Does it again here as he pushes into hook. Looks like he's probably going to get shut down here. No! Manages to get the frag. He's now going to actually go back through ramp, so Keeping 3D Max guessing here. Looks like they are going to drop. Kassad moving in. Is he going to find the AK-47 frag here? He's not. That's going to be shut down. And really, 3D Max now, if they got this rotation in quicker, they would have been in a much better position. I mean, Cappy's only just now dropped vents. The bomb's going down. He peeks to try and stop the plant. Not going to stop it. He's not nearly quick enough to stop that. And he's shut down. That was pretty embarrassing there from a player who has played pretty well so far. Looks like B-Dog's going to possibly think about saving this weapon here. He's in a 3-on-1. This will put, obviously, Esports Serbia on game point, but that could very well be the difference between a draw, 1 point, and you know, receiving no points from the game. So.
Yeah, I mean, pushing out there from the vents when you hear the bomb, it's not a stupid idea, but you need to, when you're in a 2v3, you're putting so much at risk. Like, pushing two guys simultaneously will obviously have a lot greater chance of success. So if you poke out like he did, you kind of need to see the guy planning the bomb through the vents.
The one thing I will say to that, there was smoke cover down on the site, though, to the right-hand side.
Yeah, and that would have
improved his chances of going for the aggressive peak, which is why I would have gone for the aggressive peak then.
Okay.
Because obviously window and right door, you know, towards the open vent side, basically they were shut down by the smoke.
Yeah.
So if I was in his position, I mean, hindsight's 20/20, I probably wouldn't have been able to make this call on the fly. But if I was given, say, you know, like 20 seconds to think about it, it would be to just straight rush at that plant whilst that smoke's down. And then they could have stopped the plant, played the clock, you know, been a little bit smarter about it, but oh well, you know, spilt milk and all that.
But it's game point here, and it's 5v4 in favor. Oh no, it's pretty max replies, it's 4v4. But what's going to happen here, Joe?
Well, we're seeing ESports Serbia just absolutely dominate that ramp room. That's been pretty much the go-to push here. Between that and outside, that's what they've made their bones. I mean, I've seen the flash going down. Not bad flash anyway. It would have flash-banged him completely blind. But as you can see, just one member left alive, and that's going to be the complete shutdown. So GG though. That's going to be a scoreline of 16-13 in favour of what has to be said has been one of the surprise dark horses of the tournament. ESports Serbia, they've pleasantly surprised me so far.
Yeah, I have to agree. A little update on you. I'm just...